When on a photography trip, you always look forward to sunrise and sunset. And on the second morning of our trip to Scotland, we were greeted with no sunrise. However, not long after that, we were spoiled because we had rain, quickly followed by rainbows. And when your day starts like this, you know it's going to be a good day.
Welcome back to the channel, welcome back to the vlog. Today you join me at the beginning of day two of our trip to Scotland. And what we've decided to do is come back to a location actually that we finished up on the end of day one, which is the Cascades on the base of Buachaille Etive Mor. Now, we didn't come to the traditional location, but we said because we were staying close by here, we'd come and look at it for this morning. And it's actually quite nice because the whole night last night, it rained quite heavy. So what that has done is increased the flow that we have here coming through of water. Now it's raining as well, on and off here as well this morning, so we didn't even bother getting up for sunrise. It's now around 11 a.m, so we had a nice leisurely morning, and we're going to heading off now next over onto the Isle of Skye. But we said we'd come back and have a look and see what it's like. Now I've never been here before, so like most of these bucket shots, I've never seen them because I've never been here before. So I'll of course take my version of a photograph that I can see has been taken by many, many people over the years. You've probably got around three compositions that you can get in this one general location. One I think is here, there's another one over this side and to the left of you, and then there's the main bucket list shot I think, which is over on the right hand side here, which gives you a nice view of some Cascades that you can kind of get close enough to. So I'll end up taking all three of those shots, and I'll see them when I can get out of each of those images. I'll probably take them in landscape, and I'll also probably take them in portrait, and just to see which ones that I prefer. This morning, actually, it's quite tough as well because the amount of midges that are around here. I was talking to the guys earlier on, and in mid-talking, I swallowed a couple of them. They went straight into my mouth. There was that many of them. So I put on midge repellent spray, which does seem to be working. It's a lot less, actually, over here by the water than what it was where we parked the car. But nonetheless, you know, before the rain goes or before the rain comes back, I'll grab these shots anyway, and then we'll be heading off on our journey and we'll hopefully catch some dynamic light as well en route to Skye. So still on our route to Skye, and we stopped off at this absolutely beautiful castle. It's quite iconic. Everybody, I think, that passes this way pulls in, judging by the car park as well. Everybody who's on their way has parked here. But the light at the moment now as well is shining right behind me here, so not much real drama, but did get a nice bit of light actually on the hills in the distance here. What I've done is gone for pretty classic composition, and I've put on my 10 stop to get a long exposure, and also using my 0.9 ND grad just to control that sky as well. But I think, yeah, as you're here, you know, might as well get the shot. Got this one anyway, might take a walk up here and see what other compositions I can get. But onwards we continue now on our road trip to Skye. As we're driving on the way here now, still on the way to Skye, the light that we're getting in the mountains is absolutely incredible. I've been using the camera going out the window here, taking some shots, and the dynamicness of this light is incredible. The topography of the mountains is beautiful. The clouds going in and out of them as well is really, really good for some great shots. I'm really excited now to see what the remainder of the day will actually bring to us as we get to Skye, because, you know, I think the weather, it's a bit schizophrenic. It's raining and then it's sunny, it's raining and it's sunny, which is perfect, because we're going to get some incredible light shows, I think, throughout the remainder of the journey to Skye.
Can you explain some of the feckin' words that you just said there in that, like, what?
Oh, the light is just getting better and better as we're going over these mountains here. It's incredible. I think I've gotten some number of shots, like I said, that I've gotten out the window there. I'll show you a couple of them there now as well, and you'll see what we experience on this road trip. Thank you.
Now, I know it's an old cliche, you know, don't focus on the destination, enjoy the journey, but definitely, for us anyway today, besides Dermot's company, of course, but I've been really enjoying the journey. We finally made it to Skye, and my God, look at the view that I have behind me here. What an introduction. It's the first place now that we stopped at, and the light is just dancing across the mountains that are behind us here with this stream. So I've got my camera set up below me here. It's doing a time lapse, and hopefully that will turn out nice as well. I've taken a couple of shots as well. It's beautiful. What an introduction to this stunning place. It's been very difficult to even keep my eye on the road, but thankfully I'm not driving. Dermot's been doing the driving, so it's been great to be able to have the camera and capture the light as it dances across the beautiful mountains that are here. This is going to be an exceptional trip. I'm really excited now to be able to see what lies ahead.
Right, so here we are on a place that I know that Dermot, as you can see here below me, has been constantly going on about that he wanted to return. He'd unfinished business here, and it's the fairy pools on the Isle of Skye. And it was the first place that we made a beeline to, because like I said, he hasn't stopped talking about it probably for the last maybe 4 years since he was here last anyway. And what we have is some beautiful cascades that are here, and then with a peak that's behind it, and there's some beautiful light now as well hitting that peak. I'm going to try and get down and get a shot in a moment. Hopefully I still have the light. You know, there's some nice broken clouds as well. What I've noticed today is that the light has been exceptional. We were absolutely spoiled for light for this entire trip so far. Even though it rained quite a lot in between the showers, it was beautiful. And now, right now in this spot, I can see why he likes it. It looks really, really nice, but I've got a small bit of a scramble to get down to the water area there to compose my shot. So I'm going to go down now, and I'm going to try and grab the quintessential shot of the fairy pools on Skye. So I went down, and I think I got a nice shot, actually. Now, to be fair, like I said earlier on, Dermot has wanted to come back here for a long, long time. And when I just arrived, the light was shining right on the peak here, which is behind the beautiful waterfalls you see down there. And Dermot is like pig in shit. He's happy out, he's gotten that shot, and to be fair to him, that is a nice shot. I looked at the back of the camera, and I think my own shot actually as well was nice. I got a small bit of a pocket of light that was on the central area here, but what an impressive place it is to come take some photographs. Good old hike actually to come to the very most furthest part really, but it's worth it to be able to get there. So this is the end of my second day, my first day really on Skye. It's been action-packed, like I said from earlier on when I first arrived here. The light that we got today was phenomenal. So here, I think with the shots that I've taken a number of different types of exposures, got some nice light as well, like I said, on the back of that. But nonetheless, the image itself was phenomenal. Using my polarizer, I could see all of the rocks and everything else that are below here. And the water is crystal clear. So it's obviously fed from rainwater coming down from the mountains here. It's crystal clear. Patrick, a moment ago, went for a bit of a swim in the water as well. Brave man, it's really, really cold. But he seemed to like it. He's nice and refreshed as well from that. So I'm going to finish up on today's episode. Thank you very much, as always, for joining me. Hope you've enjoyed coming along on the journey today to reach Skye. Now we've got our third day tomorrow, and I'm really looking forward now to seeing the places that we go and the images that we get. So until the next time, Schlange Fall.
How's the field have gotten your bucket shot?
It's like a big massive itch in your back and you can't itch it for ages, and it's driving absolutely insane. And then did you ever get to one of those stupid presents and someone brings you back from Hallows with a back scratcher?
Mm-hmm.
You get it and you scratch and it's just like, ah! That multiplied by 100.
A well-deserved beer.
Oh, touche.
Sláinte.
Scorn or Scott.